Welcome everybody. The objective of this lecture is to understand design of full subtractor. So full subtractor is also one type of combinational circuit. So now let's see how to design this full subtractor. So in previous presentation we have seen what is half subtractor. Half subtractor is a logic circuit which has two inputs. It performs a subtraction between that two input where size of each input is 1 bit. And it produces two output. So first one is difference and second one is power. So that half subtractor has one problem. So what is that problem? We have seen half adder and full adder. Why full adder is there? Because half adder cannot be used in case of multi-bit addition. Same case is applicable to half subtractor and full subtractor. Half subtractor cannot be used in multi-bit subtraction. So in multi-bit subtraction, we require the subtractor which has three inputs. Okay. So that's why we have full subtractor. So I hope now the difference may be clear to you, the difference between half subtractor and full subtractor. So half subtractor has only two inputs and for full subtractor there will be three inputs. So we have full subtractor which is used for multi-bit subtraction. Now before discussing design of full subtractor, let's see some example of binary subtraction. So some students may be knowing how to carry out a binary subtraction, some may not be knowing. So if you are knowing, you can skip this part. Those who are not knowing, they can concentrate here. Now let's assume that we want to perform subtraction between these two numbers. So our first binary number is 1010. So what is the decimal equivalent of 1010? So all again and again I am telling that you should be able to convert binary number into decimal number into binary number. Okay, so 1010. If I convert it into decimal, 0010. So this is also binary number. Decimal equivalent is 2. Okay, so we are expecting that here result should be. So from 10 we are subtracting 2. So we are expecting result 8. Now let's see how it will be carried out. So in order to perform this subtraction, what you have to do, just you have to remember the rules of binary subtraction. We have seen rules of binary subtraction in half subtractor. So those rules are simple. Okay, so consider first case, that is 0 minus 0. So what this says, 0 minus 0, very straightforward case. So 0 minus 0, difference will be 0 and borrow will be 0. Okay, so next case is 1 minus 1. So this is also a simple straightforward case. From 1 we are subtracting 1, so here difference will be 0 and borrow will be 0. Then next case is 1 minus 0. This is also straightforward case. So 1 minus 0, so difference will be 1 and no borrow. So I can say that these three cases of binary subtraction are straightforward, easy to remember. Now some students are finding a difficulty in this case, 0 minus 1. Okay, so 0 minus 1, from smaller number we are subtracting larger number, so this subtraction is not possible. So it will require borrow, so this borrow can be taken from next bit position. So rules of binary subtraction says that if we are trying to subtract 1 from 0, then difference will be 1 and here borrow will be generated. So just you have to remember these four rules, right? So 0 minus 1, difference is 1 as well as borrow is 1. And in other three cases of binary subtraction, there is no borrow. So keeping all these things in mind, let's try to do this binary subtraction. So 0 minus 0. So 0 minus 0, I told you that this is straightforward case, difference will be 0, no borrow. Then 1 minus 1. Again difference will be 0, 0 minus 0, difference will be 0, then 1 minus 0, straightforward case, 1 minus 0, yes, difference is 1. So what result we are getting? 1 and 3 times 0. So if I convert this binary number into decimal, I will get 8. Okay, so we have got a required result. Now, let's see one more example. Okay, now consider this next example. So here, 1 3 times 0, So this is binary number. If I convert it into a decimal, I will get 8. Then next binary number is 0, 3 times 1. Okay. So from this, if I convert this binary number into decimal, then its decimal equivalent will be 7. So we want to perform which operation? 8 minus 7. 8 minus 7, we are expecting result as 1. Now, so see how we are getting this 1. So consider first case. In first case, what we have to do? Which operation we have to do? 0 minus 1. So 0 minus 1, already we have seen 0 minus 1, right? In this case, what we do? We consider difference as 1 and borrow will be 1. Okay, so see 0 minus 1. So here I have written that difference. Difference is 1. Okay, and in this case, borrow is also generated. So that borrow we are supposed to write here. Okay, we are supposed to write that borrow at next bit position. Now see, at next position, what is happening? Now we are having 3 bits. One is 0, then 1, and then this 1. Right? So here we have to perform subtraction of these 3 bits. 0, minus 1, minus 1. Okay. Now let's start. So consider these 2 bits, 0, minus 1. So 0, minus 1, what it says, difference will be 1. Okay. So I will write that difference here. Okay. So 0, minus 1, difference is 1. Borrow is generated. Right. So that borrow I will write here. So see. So this is borrow which is generated due to this. Okay, so 0 minus 1, difference is 1 and borrow is generated. I will write that borrow at next bit position. Okay, now what is difference we are getting here? 1. So this difference 1 minus this borrow 1. So 1 minus 1. So see what is the result here? 0. Okay. Now see what is happening at next bit position. Again here we have 3 bits, 0, 1 and 1. Okay, now consider 0 minus 1. What is 0 minus 1? So 0 minus 1, again difference will be 0 minus 1. So 0 minus 1, what will be the difference? So difference will be 1. Are you getting? I will write that difference here. Whether borrow will be generated? Yes, borrow is generated. I will write that borrow at next bit position. Okay, so 0 minus 1 is over. What difference we are getting? 1. From this difference, so we should subtract this 1. So 1 minus 1. Yes, what is the result? 0. Okay, now let's move to the next bit position. Now here we have 3 bit 1, 0, 1. So we have to perform operation like 1 minus 0, minus 1. So 1 minus 0. First of all, perform this operation. Yes, 1 minus 0. So 1 minus 0, whether borrow will be generated? No, difference will be 1. Okay, now from this 1, subtract this 1. So 1 minus 1, whether borrow will be generated? No, difference will be 0. So that difference we will get here. So what result we are getting? 3 times 0, 1. So convert it into decimal, we get 1. Okay, so I hope you understood how to carry out this binary subtraction. So, in case of multi-bit subtraction, so this is multi-bit subtraction. Whatever examples we discuss, these are multi-bit subtraction, because here we are trying to perform subtraction between two numbers, pair size of each number is more than 1 bit. So, what is problem with multi-bit subtraction? So, in case of multi-bit subtraction, at some position, we are supposed to perform subtraction between 3 bits, 0, 0 and in this case, suppose this is 1. So why this 1 is generated? Because see, at previous bit position, what is happening? 0 minus 1. So 0 minus 1, difference will be 1 and borrow will be generated. So I told you that we are supposed to write that borrow here. Okay, so at next bit position, at next position, now we have 3 bits, 0, 0, 1. So we have to perform subtraction of this 3 bit. So here we will require a subtractor which will have 3 inputs, and that subtractor is nothing but full subtractor. Okay, now I hope it is clear to you why full subtractor is there. So in case of full subtractor, I can say that there are 3 inputs. So first will be a, then second will be a b, and third one will be a b in. We will call this third input as b in. So what is b in? It is borrow from previous stage. Okay, So this is borrow, which is generated due to previous stage subtraction. And it has two output. So first one is difference and second one is B out, that is borrow. Now let's see block diagram of full subtractor. So it is very simple. We have seen that full subtractor has three input, A, B and B in. So it is B in, we can say that it is borrow, which is generated due to previous stage subtraction, due to a lower bit subtraction. So full subtractor will perform subtraction of these three bits and it is going to generate these two output. One is difference and second one is B out. So please don't get confused between B in and B out. So B in is a borrow from previous stage and B out is a borrow which is generated at that current stage. Now truth table. So how many columns should be present in truth table of full subtractor? Yes, so there are three input and two output. So 3 plus 2, that is 5. So there will be total 5 columns. So truth table for full subtractor will be like this. Now let's try to understand how this truth table is designed. So in order to design this truth table, first of all, what you are supposed to do, you are supposed to write all input combination. So how many inputs are there? 3. So by using 3 inputs, how many combinations are possible? 2 raised to 3. So first of all, write all those 8 input combination. So 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 and 1 1 1. So you should be able to write all these input combination. So these are just binary number in sequence. Okay, so this is 0 1 2 3 4 5 6 and this is 7, 1 1 1 in binary. If I convert it into decimal, I will get 7. Just you have to write this binary number in sequence. After that, for each input combination, you are supposed to write outputs. So consider first input combination 0 0 0. So we know that full subtractor is producing two output. First one is a difference and second one is borrow. B out. Okay, so what full subtractor is going to do? It is going to perform this operation A minus B minus B in. A minus B minus B in. So see 0 minus 0, 0, 0 minus 0, 0. So see difference and borrow both will be 0. So straightforward case. Now this is somewhat complicated. 0, 0, 1. Okay, so consider first two bits 0 minus 0. So 0 minus 0, again it is straightforward. Result will be 0. Right? And this 0 minus 1. So 0 minus 1. Try to recall rules of binary subtraction. 0 minus 1. What it says? It says that difference will be 1 and borrow will also be 1. So see, that's why here we have written difference as 1 and borrow as 1. I hope it is clear to you. Then consider this next row. So for next row, what is input combination? 0, 1, 0. So first of all 0 minus 1, right? So 0 minus 1, in this case what happens? The difference will be 1 and borrow will also be generated, right? So difference is 1. So from this 1 you are supposed to subtract 0. So 1 minus 0, what will be the final difference? Final difference will be 1 and borrow will also be 1. So see, that's why here you can see 1 1. Then consider next row 0, 1, 1. Right? So first of all, consider these two bits 0 minus 1. So for 0 minus 1, what is going to happen? Yes, we know difference will be 1 and a borrow will be generated. I will write that borrow here. So let's assume that this is borrow. Right? So 0 minus 1, difference is 1 and borrow is 1. So this part is over. Right? Now from this difference we are supposed to subtract this 1. Okay, so from this difference, so which difference we are getting here? 1. So from this difference subtract this next bit. So next bit is 1. Okay, so 1 minus 1, 1 minus 1, what will be the final difference? 0. So see, here we are getting that final difference 0 and borrow is 1. So you are supposed to write that borrow here. So somewhat confusing. So let me explain it again. So see what we have to do here, which operation? 0 minus 1 minus 1. So 0 minus 1, we know that in this case difference will be 1. So consider that this is difference, and borrow will be 1. So that borrow I will write here. Okay. So let's assume that this is borrow. Then from this difference, now we have to subtract next bit, which is next bit 1. So I will write that 1 here. So 1 minus 1. What rules of binary subtraction says? 1 minus 1, 0. Right? So see, final difference is 0. And this borrow 1 will come here. Now I hope it is clear to you. Then consider next input combination, straightforward. 1 minus 0, difference is 1. There is no question of borrow, because from larger number we are subtracting smaller number. No borrow. So see, borrow is 0. So 1 minus 0, 1. That 1 minus again 0. So final difference will be 1. Then this case is also straightforward. 1 minus 0. 1 minus 0, difference will be 1. And from this 1 again you have to subtract 1. So 1 minus 1, difference and borrow both will be 0, 0. Right? Now this is also straightforward. 1 minus 1 is 0. And 0 minus 0. So difference is 0 as well as borrow is 0. Okay. Now last case, again it is somewhat confusing. 1 minus 1 minus 1. So 1 minus 1, simple, straightforward, 0. Right? 1 minus 1, so difference will be 0. No borrow. Now from this difference, what we have to do? We have to subtract this one. This one is remaining. So 0 minus 1. So 0 minus 1, we know that difference is 1 and borrow is also 1. So see, that's why here I have written difference as 1 and borrow as 1. So this is truth table for full subtractor. Okay, so please try to understand it carefully. So students are making mistakes while preparing this truth table. Just what you have to do, you have to remember rules of binary subtraction. Okay, and try to understand that full subtractor is performing operation like A minus B minus B. Now, what will be the next step? Yes, we have to design K-map. We have to draw the K-map. So how many K-map will be required here? Yes, number of K-map will depend upon number of output. Full subtractor has two output. One is difference, second one is borrow. So that's why here we will require two K-map. Then what type of K-map? 2, 3 or 4 variables. So it will depend upon number of input. How many input? Full subtractor has 3 input. So that's why we should use 3 variable K-map. Now let's see K-map for difference. So K-map for difference will be like this. So how I have drawn this K-map? So just I have represented the information which is present in truth table in this K-map. Okay, so these are the three inputs A, B and B in. So after representing information from truth table on K-map, what is the next step? You have to make the groups. Why we are making use of K-map? In order to obtain minimized Boolean expression. Okay, so then next step is make the group. So how many groups are possible here? Can we make group of 2, 1, 4, 1, 8, 1 here? No, it is not possible, because here we have so here we can make group of this one, okay, group of this one, group of this one and group of this one. Okay, so see, this is first group, okay, isolated one. Then this is second group, then this will be the third group, and then you should make this last group. So after making this four group, what will be the next step? Yes, you are supposed to write the product term which is corresponding to each group. Okay, so for this group, which will be the product term? Why we are writing product term? Why not sum term? Because here we are making group of 1. Please try to understand. Okay, so what will be the product term that will correspond to this particular group? Yes, here value of A is 0, B is 0 and B in is 1. So A prime, B prime, B in. So see, A prime, B in. Similarly, for this group, it will be A prime, then B, B in prime, A prime, B, B in prime. Then for this group it will be A, then B prime and B in prime. A, B prime, B in prime. And for this group it will be A, B, B in. So in this way we can make the groups. Okay. So see, on this slide I have now drawn that final K-map. And after making groups, after deciding the product term which are corresponding to each group, what is the next step? You are supposed to write expression for difference. So difference is equal to. So expression for difference can be obtained just by taking OR operation between all these product term. Now, you can simplify this logical expression further. It is possible to express this particular expression in terms of XOR operation. Okay. So same case we have discussed in full adder. So if you compare expression for sum in full adder with expression that you are getting for difference in full subtractor. So you will find that these two expressions are equal. So just try to compare these two expressions. Okay, now you can express this particular expression in terms of XOR operation, so that we will get expression for difference something like this: A XOR B XOR B in. Okay, now let's see KMap for borrow. So KMap for borrow will be like this. So A B and sorry, here it should be B in. So A B and B in are the inputs. Okay, so now let's try to make the group. So how many groups are possible here? So can we make group of 2 1? Yes, it is possible to make group of 2 1, right? So for example, I can combine this one with this one. So these 2 1s are adjacent, so this one group is possible. Okay, so now let's see the grouping. So this is first group, that is possible here. Then after making this group, whether any one is remaining? Yes, so here I have one and here also I have one. So can we combine this one with this one which is already covered in some other group? Yes, these 2 1 are adjacent to one another, so we can make this group. Can we combine this one with this one? Yes, these 2 1s are adjacent, so we can make group of 2 1 also. So in this way we are getting how many groups here? Here we are getting 3 groups. Okay, 3 pair. After that, what you have to do? You have to write the product term which is corresponding to each and every group. Okay, so for example, if I consider this particular group, okay, so consider this group. So for this group, what will be the product term? So how we write that product term? So while writing product term, we have to check which variables are remaining constant and which variables are remaining variables are changing. So for this particular group, A is changing. Okay, so you see here it is 0. For this group, here it is 0, here it is 1, it is changing, so discard it. Then for this group, what is value of B and B in? It is 1 1. Okay, so here it is 1 1. So that's why what will be the product term that will correspond to this particular group? It will be B into B in, right? Similarly, if I consider this second pair, okay, so for this pair, whether A is constant? Yes, value of A is constant, it is 0. Okay, so that's why we have to consider here A prime. Okay, then come here, B, what about B? B is changing. Then what about B in? B in is constant and it is 1. So what will be the term that will correspond to this particular pair? It will be, yes, A prime into B in. Okay, so in this way you can write product term from this KMap. So see, I have drawn that KMap again here. Then expression for B out. So expression for B out will be this one. Okay, so for this group, already I told you that we will get B into B in. So see, this is B into B in. Then for this group, we will get A prime into B in. So A prime into B in. And for this group, we will get A prime. Okay, and here A prime into B. So A prime into B. So this is expression for B out.